So,
hello. I've got somebody that thinks the bullying. Less than ideal. Weather's piss poor. Everybody's here. I've swept up, so they've all come to the fence. We can have a bit of a look around now and a chat. Another gander at some cattle, I suppose. So, we've got a high flyer cross blonde here. She was the Christmas Day section, had the cast iron calf. Here he's at the back there. That's a Lancelot out of the matriarch. This is another one off the matriarch family. External pelvic area does correlate with internal on these, so they look big, they are big. This is one of the last remaining cows off an Angus family, whom the entirety were culled, and they pretty much culled the lot in 1 year just because they became such dickheads at calving. Like, one cow switched at 5 year old, the next one at three, the next one at two. This lass has got a reprieve for now because she's got the high flyer element in the mix, and she is incredibly placid at the minute. Now, if that switches next year, she'll get the same treatment, but you'd hope that if four out of five were wankers, one might not be. She's getting every hope for her because she is a good quality mum. I'll go and find the calf in a minute. So if you remember her, she is S7. That's one of the only roans I've ever had off high flyer. This is a Rye Mill Lion King off the same dam line as that. So this one is out of this one's grandam. That's the Kicky Twat, days are numbered. Another high flyer blonde, same way bred as the one at that end. This is off the matriarch line. This is the daughter of this one here. That was her first calf. So, quality. Rube, Lancelot, out of this old girl here. So don't ever be fooled by phenotype when there's a serious genotype behind it. We can come back to that subject another day. Another carbon copy of that one down there off the matriarch line. That's a high flyer again. Another high flyer, first carver. Another high flyer, full sister to this one. You'll notice that the families tend to stick together. This is one of the first to have had an Orinoco calf. Stonking heifer calf. She's obviously a Lancelot. Blonde high flyer. Now this is one of the only blonde sired females are kept out of a high flyer. Her mother is quality. She had a phenomenal Belgian heifer this time round by Amaru off the good mood. So I'll show you her mother in another video. Another blonde high flyer. Another high flyer out of the matriarch line, same as that spotty one down the bottom end. This is a pedigree stacking this of, if I remember right, Clayfield's Jester, High Flyer and Grey Mar Mars. I'll double check that just because I am wrong, but she had the twins. Another blonde High Flyer. I've got the Angus family down there that was dicks. This is a direct Lancelot off a different Angus cross limb family, and she was the only female off that line that was ever worth keeping. Again, had a super Orinoco calf. This one here is a Lancelot out of a cow very similar to this cow. Maybe won't quite the same standard of quality, but it's the polish she puts on. She's had a line back to popcorn. It's a smarty pants, didn't really need any introduction. This is another high flyer. Lancelot out of the Lynn Friesian. And then this is one of the only Rye Mill Lambs that's done any good out of a Tamon Galahad cow originally. So she's three quarter blue. So I'll pause there and we'll go and have a look around the cars. Alright, so I had a bit of flannel about them all in the passageway at the last video. This is them in their group pen now. There's a good lot of them in eating because I've pushed the silage up. And it's always a great novelty seeing the same silage move closer. This is pretty. My fly daughter. One of the matriarch line, one of the special ones, as is evident. She is mother to Queenie. What have we got here? That's an Iver out of this heifer, or first calver, coming towards you. She's a Rye Mill Lion King, basically the only one that was any good, really. And she's off the matriarch family, but it's a different branch. Instead of being Neurotic High Flyer, her grandsire was Tamhorn Galahad, another Ballygrain Gaelic son. This is Ruby, who backbreeding is a bit heavy and unfortunately had a big hiver calf, and well, it gave up in the process of birth. Bit of a bugger, but 52 kilo calf did come out the back, so she's got a second chance. That's one of the oldest, biggest ivers. That's a Partisan. One of the twins here. This is a high flyer cross blonde. And that is her Mambo heifer calf. Cracking thing, that is. Cowmaker all day long. That's another high flyer. And that is her Iver. Then we've got a popcorn, I think, here. Yeah. That's popcorn out of that high fly heifer. And the Lancelot cross. This is out of one of the very last blonde Friesian cows I had. And I would love to have known what blonde was in the back breeding, because the genotype potential is shared with Ruby's back breeding. One of them cows that breeds tremendously well versus how she actually looks. She's got a real good calf as well. It's this one. This is a popcorn. Long as a train. Good calf. That's Queenie, who is the daughter of Pretty. Here's the cow maker. Batman, one of the twins. He's doing remarkably well considering he's been fostered. That's another Mambo off the matriarch line. Source of square calf, that's Misty. That's a popcorn off the high flyer cross blonde. What have we got here? Come on, haven't we? That's an Orinoco. And her mother is this Lineback Angus. So you've got the calf as a reference there. And look at the polish Orinoco has put on this cow. Look. Boy's done a job there, hasn't he? Put some width in as well. And to be fair to the Angus in that back breeding, it was a massive pelvic area. But yeah, he's put some class on there, and I'm pleased he's kept the colour in. It's probably one of the best Iver heifers. Serious length there, no prizes for guessing. It's off the High Flyer family again. That's an Iver out of another Lancelot, and the lineback colouring's come through there. This here is the Castar Christmas Day section, and I don't know what he's going to turn out like, but he's a weapon, isn't he? Hang on. Serious calf. This is one of the youngsters. That's a popcorn out of the High Flyer. Nice little thing. And that's a Lancelot out of a High Flyer blonde. I think that's pretty much got them in here. We've got the only hiding in the creek, go and have a look. So there's quite a few hiding in the creek. That's the Orinoco out of a Lion King that was a section, unfortunately, but proven fault in the dam line, because that lad over there was also a section out of a very similar bred cow. Another Lancelot out of an Orinoco, out of a High Flyer cross blonde. Is going to be a fair thing. He's not very old, is he? Then I'm pleased with this one as well. This is a Zester Circuit out of a High Flyer cross, and he is very nearly the youngest. No, he is. He's 29th of January, the same as Oprah's twins. They were the last lot to be born. So he's only, what, 6 weeks old, but real good calf. I think a few more sneaked out. Oh, we've got the duck chest here as well, look. Okay. Good. You get up? No? Come on. Up you get. Come on. Oh, so she's a youngster as well. Lovely natured calf, that. Made up with the colour. Big fan of the colour in a tester, so to get a real deep blue roan like that, obviously pleased with. And the cow family she's off are the ones turning out sort of 250 centimetre squared pelvises at a year old, so I'm hoping she follows the same path. Whatever you think of either, that's out of a heifer, isn't it? For a heifer's calf. But then, you'd be equally as pleased with that, and that's another Orinoco. So, yeah, for the proper heifer, there's a Cerberus as well. I ought to have been counting the calves as I was walking around, didn't I? Go on, kid. That's the Cerberus calf that had the dam that did not like her for the best part of a month, really. It took a bit of moving around and stopping a mother from mothering another calf, and now they're getting on with each other. So that'll make a nice cow. I'm not that happy with the Cerberus bull. I put Cerberus on my old mate. Old matriarch cow, expecting to get a real classy effort, and I got complete lanky wanky of a bull calf, but it might thicken out. I think that'll make a cow though. But yeah, I'll call it a do on this video, and we'll go and have a look in the other pen there, where the Cerberus bull is. That's the calf to end on, isn't it?